Welcome to Solving Source classes. In this video, we are solving the UGC NET question paper English of the year 2020. In this video, we are going to start from question number 81. Question number 81 says, match the list. List 1. One contains famous lines of some poems. The lines are A. Monuments of unaging intellect. Rag and bone shop of the heart. C. So mastered by the brute blood of the air. And D, as weary hearted as the hollow moon. List 2 contains the names of the poems. Lydda and the Swan. Two. Adam's Curse. Three. Sailing to Byzantium. The circus animal's desertion. So these are the titles of the poem. Now, as we can see, all the poems are by W.B. Yeats. You have to connect the correct line which appears in the poem with the poem. So correct line with the correct title. Choose the correct answer. Option number 1, A3, B4, C2, D1. Option 2, A3, B1, C4, D2. Option number 3, A3, B4, C1, D2. and option number 4, A2, A2, B1, C4, D3. Now the correct combination is option number 3. Option number 3 is the correct combination. So A, Monuments of Unaging Intellect goes with Sailing to Byzantium. So A goes with 3. In the Foul Rat and Bone Shop of Heart goes with The Circus Animals Desertion. So B goes with 4. C goes with 1, so mastered by the brute blood of the air goes with Lydda and the Swan, and finally as very hearted as the hollow moon goes with Adam's curse. So D2, so A3, B4, C1, D2. So option number 3 is the correct answer. Option number 3. Question number 82. Given below are two statements. One is labeled assertion A and other is labeled as reason R. So what is A? Assertion A says, the introduction of English in India was primarily for the benefit and consolidation of British power. The introduction of English in India was primarily for the benefit and consolidation of British power. Reason R states, English catered to the social and economic aspirations of the emerging middle class and urban elites in India. English catered to the social and economic aspirations. Of the emerging middle class and urban elites in India. So that's a reason labeled as reason R. So R. Now the question is, in light of the above statements, choose the correct answers from the option given below. options are: one, both A and R are true, but R, both A and R are true, and R is the correct explanation of A. Number two, both A and R are true, but R is not the correct explanation of A. Number three, A is true but R is false. And number four, A is false but R is true. So these are your four options, and the correct answer would be number two, which says both A and R are true. We can understand from both the statements that both are actually correct. The introduction of English in India actually happened the British Empire could be, the power of the British Empire could be consolidated, cemented in a more strong way, and R, which states that English catered to the social and economic aspirations of the emerging middle class and the urban elites in India, is also correct. But R is not exactly the correct explanation for A. So both the statements are correct, both the statements are true, but R is not really the correct explanation for A. English was introduced in India for the benefit and the consolidation of the British power, so that the British official works could be carried on in a smoother way, not because it catered to the requirements of the urban middle class. R is not exactly the correct explanation of A, although it is true. So option number two is the correct answer, which says that both A and R are true, but R is not the correct explanation of A. So option number two is the correct answer. Question number 83. Which two rivers are mentioned by Andrew Marvel at the beginning of To His Coy Mistress? That's the question. The names of the rivers given to you are: A, the Ganges; B, Thames; C, Humber; the Jhelum. correct answer. Option 1, E and D. Number 2, A and B. Number 3, A and C. And number 4, B and C. So these are your options, and the correct option is A and C. So option number 3. The rivers that Andrew Marvel mentions in his poem to his coy mistress are the Ganges and Humber. The Ganges, as we know, is from India, and Humber is in Canada. So A and C is the correct answer. Ganges and Humber. So option number 3. Question number 84. Which two terms among the following are associated with formalist criticism? The terms are A, aura, B, actant, C, narrative, D, familiarization. So these are the terms given to you. Choose the correct answer. The options are number 1, A and C. Number 2, B and D. Number 3, B and C. And number 4, D and E. That's right. So these are the options. The correct answer is D and E. So defamiliarization and foregrounding. So therefore, option number 4 is the correct answer. Formalist criticism, as we know, is the form of criticism where the text itself is studied as an artifact. Anything that lies outside the text, or the structural format of the text, is not held into consideration, not brought into consideration by the formalist critics. So, say the thematic context of the text, or how the text responds to questions of gender or sexuality, or the background of the author of the text, or the backdrop of the text. All these questions are not brought into consideration by formalist criticism. Only the text itself, as a matter of artifact, is studied. So the structural formatting of the text is the main concern of study of the formalist criticism. And in that context, defamiliarization and foregrounding are the two terms, two aspects that are primarily associated to the formalist criticism. So therefore, option number 4, D and E, is the correct answer. Question number 85. The lives of which of the following writers have been the subject matter of novels by Anthony Burgess? The names of the writers given to you are A. Milton, B. Marlowe, C. Shelley, D. Keats. Choose the correct answer. 1. A and B. Was greatly interested in, and he has written novels on the lives of Marlowe and Keats, although Marlowe himself in the novel doesn't appear, but he's spoken about by other characters, and the subject of his life and his death, the controversy regarding his death has been the primary focus of his works. So, Marlowe and Keats. Burgess also wrote extensively on Shakespeare and the death of Chatterton. But anyway, from the options given to us over here, Marlowe and Keats is the correct answer. So, option number 4, B and D, is the correct answer. Question number 86. A research hypothesis is A. A proposition which is always true. Explanation of anything. C. A theory which will be disapproved by evidence. Statement which is assumed to be true for the sake of argument. So these are the statements about a research hypothesis given to you. You have to choose the correct two of the correct of them. Choose the correct answer. Option number one, A and B. Number two, B and C. Number three, B and D. And number four, A and C. The correct explanations are, the correct statements are B and D. So B, a provisional explanation of anything. Research hypothesis is a provisional explanation of something and of a proposition. And D, it is a statement which is assumed to be true for the sake of argument. So it is not a proposition which is always true. It cannot be always true. And it is not a theory which will be disproved by evidence. So hypothesis can be correct, a research hypothesis may not be correct. So it is subject to experiments and study. So when a hypothesis is made, it is assumed to be, it's often assumed to be correct for the sake of argument, so that research can be carried on further on it, and it is a provisional explanation of something. So B and D are the correct statements. So option number three is the correct answer. B and D. Option number three. Question number 87. Who among the following was the first director of the Central Institute of English and Foreign Languages, Hyderabad, now also known as the EFL University or the EFLU? Who among the following was the first director of the Central Institute of English and Foreign Languages?